Welcome students. In our today's class, we are going to discuss about International English Olympiad workbook. We are going to discuss each chapter of this book in our successive videos. So, for today's class, we are going to discuss the first chapter. Let us see the content first. We have got word power in our first chapter. Second is antonym and synonym. Third is phrasal verbs and idiom. Then noun, pronoun, and so on. Okay. So total 15 chapters are there. Okay. So let us first begin with our first chapter. Before proceeding, this is our sample Waymer answer sheet. Whenever you sit for this kind of competitive exam, like Olympiad or any scholarship exam, you have to when the exam is happening in offline mode, you have to answer in Waymer sheets. So an Waymer sheet looks like this. Okay, here what you have to do, you have to write your name in capital letters as the instruction is given here. Then you have to put your school details, like whatever your school detail is. Then you have to write your class, like 01. If it is 01, what you have to do, you have to darken the circle like this. Okay, 0, then here 1. So this is the way. The darkening is not proper here. There is a proper way when you are doing this on pen or paper. Okay, now suppose you are answering the paper and your answer is answer for one number question is 3. So what you have to do, like one I have done for you, you have to mark this circle. Okay, like that, not in a messy way but in a proper way. Okay, so let us begin with our first chapter, that is word power. So various kind of questions can be coming from this chapter, like choose the first option A. The first segment is choose the correctly spelled word. So the four options will be given and you have to choose the correct answer. Okay, so first word is architecture. What first let us know what architecture mean. Architecture mean the complex or carefully designed structure of something, the outer structure or inner structure of a building, a temple, a mosque, anything. Okay, so here the right spelling is architecture, architecture. Okay, now the second, we are in the segment A, as you can see. Okay, let me remove this first. So in the first segment, we have to select the correctly spelled word. We have 10 questions on that. Okay, in segment B, we have to choose the homonym to complete the sentences. Now first let us start with that, the correctly spelled word. First word is architecture. What does architecture mean? Architecture means the complex or carefully designed structure of something. Okay, the structure could be of a house, a temple, a building, a office building, a school building, any building. Okay, or anything that has a complex and carefully designed structure. Now which one is the correct spelling here? Here it is the correct spelling, architecture, architecture, architecture. Okay, now the second word. What is our second word? We are on the segment A till now. Okay, so in segment A, 1, then we are moving to number 2. Here also we have to choose the correct word, choose the correctly spelled word. Now what is our second word? Our second word is mannequin. Okay, now what is the rightly spelled word of mannequin. Mannequin means a dummy used to display mannequin. Okay, a mannequin means a dummy used to display clothes in a shop window. Whenever you are passing through a road, you can see the shops nearby side by the road, and you can see those dolls wearing dresses as a model and standing there. Those are called mannequin. Those are dummy. Okay, now what is the correct spelling of mannequin? The correct spelling is option B. Okay, option B is the correct one. MANNEQUIN. Okay, let us move to the third number. Here also we have to choose the correctly spelled word. Our third word is plagiarism. So what does plagiarism mean? Plagiarism mean the practice of taking someone else's work and or ideas and passing them off as one's own. Suppose you have written a paragraph on your own and your friend just copied it from your copy without your consent or without letting you know or without mentioning your name. That would be called plagiarism, a kind of theft. Okay, theft of your ideas or your work. Okay, now what is the correct spelling of plagiarism? The correct spelling is this: plagiarism. So first was architecture, for one C, two B, and for three A. If you have to give exam on Wemmer sheet, you have to put darken the correct circle like that, as I have shown you. Now our next word is slaughter. Okay, slaughter means killing of animals for food or killing for food. Okay, now what is the correct spelling of slaughter? The correct spelling would be slaughter. Now let us move to the fifth question. Negligence. What is the meaning of negligence? Negligence, when you are not careful about something, that is called negligence. Now what would be the right spelling of negligence? Right spelling would be option A, that is negligence. Negligence. Okay, now sophisticated. Question number six. What is the meaning of the word sophisticated? So when you will be doing the correctly spelled word and all of this, at that time pronunciation would be of utmost importance, because if it's sophisticated. Okay, if you pronounce it wrong, the spelling would be wrong. Okay, sophisticated. What is the meaning of the word sophisticated? Sophisticated mean something that has a knowledge or experience about fashion and culture, that is sophisticated. What would be the right spelling of sophisticated? Sophisticated. Now coherent. Our next word is coherent. What is the correct spelling of coherent? The seven number, the correct spelling is coherent. Now cosmopolitan. Our next word, The meaning of the word cosmopolitan is that can be found, something that can be found all over the world, or indulging people from many different countries. Okay, now what is the correct spelling of cosmopolitan? As I am pronouncing the word cosmopolitan, this would be the right spelling, cosmopolitan, cosmopolitan. Okay, now let us move to the correctly spelled word. Question number A, numbering is 9. Okay, sub number is 9. Hypocrisy. Okay, hypocrisy. Now, what is hypocrisy? Mean the practice of making others small in front of your knowledge and claiming that you have high moral standard or beliefs, and others' moral standard or beliefs or other are lower than you. This is called hypocrisy. Okay, now what is the correct spelling of the word hypocrisy? Hypocrisy, the correctly spelled word would be hypocrisy. Hypocrisy. Now, resonance. What is the correctly, what would be the right answer? Resonance. R-E-S-O. This would be the right answer. R-E-S-O-N-A-N-C-E. Resonance. Okay. So, with this, we complete our choose the correctly spelled word section. Now, in the section B, what we have to do? We have to choose the correct homonym to complete the sentence. Now, what is the meaning of the word homonym? Homonym means, suppose two words are there, or more than two words, they have the same spelling or pronunciation but different meaning or origin. The meaning is different. They may look same, but the meaning, they may look same or their pronunciation may be same, but their meaning and or the origin would be different. Okay. Now, let us choose the homonyms to fill in the blanks. Sami, Jaya and Raman know dash results. What would be the correct answer? There, dear, dear, three. Okay, now the answer would be there. T-H-E-I-R. T-H-E-I-R. Suman will be Mr. Rao's legal. Here, here, here or here. Answer would be H-E-I-R. Answer would be H-E-I-R. Now, we were dashed to take pictures of the children. We were dash to take the pictures of the children. We were allowed. Allow. Allowed. Loud. Allowed. So the answer would be allowed. A-O-O-W-E-D. Suddenly Meeta. Question number 14. Suddenly Meeta started looking dash out of fear. Pale. Peel. Pale. Peel. What would be the right answer? You can see the pronunciation or words of some, spelling some in some of the cases as similar, but the meaning are completely different from each other. For question number 14, the answer would be pale. He was looking colorless. His face suddenly become colorless. Okay. In fear. So the answer would be P-A-L-E, pale. The police soon arrived at the dash of the crime. Scene of the crime would be now. What would be the answer? This scene or this scene? Which one would be correct? Scene. This is the correct answer. And this is the wrong answer. Okay. Let me erase this. Otherwise, you will be confused. Just a minute. So, scene. Now, with that, we complete this portion of homonym. Now, let us move to question number 16. Choose the correct one word substitution for the given phrases. What are phrases? Phrases are a collection of two or three or more words that suggest a single meaning. Okay. Now, for question number 16, a competition in which no party wins. What that will be called? that will be called a tie. So a single word or one word for the given phrase, a competition in which no party wins, would be tie. Water fit for drinking. What that water would be called that is fit for drinking? The water would be called potable water. Potable water. So option number C. One who makes maps and charts. Who that person is called what? That person is called a cartographer. A cartographer makes maps and charts. A person who designs buildings and supervises their construction. What that person is called? That person is called architect. A person who designs building and supervises their construction. A song in praise of God. A song that is sung in praise of God is known as hymn. Okay. Now, let us move to our next portion. Again, here we have to choose some of the correctly spelt word. The words are a bit difficult here. Okay. Now, what is our first word? Our first word is rendezvous. What is the correct spelling? It is a noun, and the meaning of the word rendezvous, it should be pronounced like this. Rendezvous, the meaning of the word, a meeting at an agreed time or place. Suppose you and your friend have agreed to meet with each other at a certain time and place, and that would be called rendezvous. To meet an agreed time and place. Now, what is the correct spelling of rendezvous? Tell me. Okay. So, the correct spelling of rendezvous would be R-E-N-D-E-Z-V-O-U-S. R-E-N-D-E-Z-V-O-U-S. Rendezvous. Now, anonymous. What is the meaning of the word anonymous? Do you guys know? Anonymous means something that has no name. Okay. Something that has got no name. This could be anonymous person, anonymous writing or anything. Now, what is the correct spelling of anonymous? A-N-O. N-Y-A-M-O-U-S. Anonymous. Whenever you have to, I am repeating this again. Whenever you are asked to choose the correctly spelt word, pronounce the word properly. It will help you to choose or guess or write the word properly. Spell the word properly. And for that you may break your pronunciation in small parts, as I am doing here, anonymous. So what I am doing, I am breaking anonymous in anonymous. So with this, my it is becoming easy for me to choose the correctly spelled word. Now, choose the correct option to fill in the blank. Again, please tell me what you have to do from A, B, C, D. From these four options, you have to choose the correct option to fill in the blanks. Please tell me the amount that is due, none of this. Which one will be the answer? Okay. In some of the cases, you may find this none of this. Okay. Most of the cases, this should not be the answer. Okay. A question paper maker will never give a question like this. Okay. But in some of the cases, this might be the right answer. Okay. So don't get confused regarding this. Now, what is the meaning of the word due? Due means something that is someone will something that is
dew. Now the right answer would be DUE. So please tell me the amount that is dew. Raman, this velvet, question number 24. Raman, this velvet dress looks really nice on you. This velvet suit. What will be the right answer? This will be the right answer. Suit means a pair of clothing. Okay. Now, this is a one word answer will be here. A person who has no belief in God is A or an. What will be the right answer? Atheist, egoist, immoral or a rebel? What will be the right answer here? Atheist is a person who doesn't have any belief in God. He doesn't believe that God exists. So atheist would be our right answer. A-T-H-E-I-E-S-T. Okay. With that, we complete our chapter. If you have the book in hard copy, you have to darken the circles like this. Suppose for one number, C is the right answer. You have to darken this circle. This is a messy way. This is not the right way. But whatever I can do with the help of my finger, I'm doing. Suppose in the case of two number, A is the right answer. You have to circle this. In the case of three, D is the right answer. You have to circle this. And like this, you have to fill up the this answer sections. Okay, students, that's all for today's video. In our next class, in our next video, I will discuss synonym and antonym and other chapters also. Okay, that's all for today. Bye.